Hello student, today we will try to understand that which transaction goes to which type of subsidiary. There are five types of subsidiary book: purchase book, sales book, purchase return book, sales return book and cash book. Along with these five subsidiary books, we also prepare general proper for the remaining transactions. So today we are trying to understand that which transaction goes to which type of book. The first transaction is goods purchased from move. So whenever we purchase goods in credit, then it will goes to purchase. Whenever we will purchase any goods in credit, it will goes to purchase. The next transaction is goods purchased from Mohan on cash. This time the goods is purchased in cash, so it will goes to cash. The next transaction is furniture purchase for cash. Here we have purchase furniture, not goods, and in cash, so it will goes to cash. Whenever we make any payment or whenever we received any payment in cash, it will always goes to cash. Next, furniture purchase on credit from ABC Furniture. Here the furniture is not purchased in cash, so it will not goes to cash book. This is furniture, not goods, so we can't record it in purchase book. So where it goes? It goes to general proper. General proper. Next transaction is paid to Mohan 29,000 in full settlement of 30,000. He paid 29,000 in cash, so 29,000 will goes to cash, and 1,000 discount that we receive will goes to general proper. The next transaction is paid salary 10,000 and outstanding salary rupees 2,000. Here we paid salary 10,000, so this 10,000 will goes to cash book. And outstanding salary that we haven't paid will goes to general proper. Next transaction, goods returned by Mohan. Whenever any goods returned to Mohan, whenever we return goods to any supplier, whenever we return goods, so it will goes to purchase return. Next, goods returned to Rao. This is also purchase return, but in place of 2 I will write by. So now this goods is returned by Ram. So Ram is our customer. So whenever any customer return goods to us, then it will goes to sales return. So to record transaction in subsidiary books, first we need to identify that which transaction goes to which type of subsidiary books. If we come to identify the transactions or proper subsidiary book, then subsidiary book is so easy. Thank you, students.